6 months ago, I wrote that Windows 11 felt unnecessary. Have I changed my opinion? Basically, no, and here's why. Even though I tested Windows 11 with the Windows Insider program prior to its launch, I wanted to take another look. Has my impression of Windows 11 improved? Yeah, it has, in places. But it's still trying to keep up with Windows 10. Windows 11's most significant flaw is that it still feels less fun and less functional. Let me give you an example. In Windows 10's settings menu, if you navigate to Personalization/Themes, you'll see large, evocative icons telling you what themes you've installed. Now, I like the Windows 11 settings menu, but themes here feel less about your personality and more like a neighborhood paint scheme that's been instituted by your HOA. It's very corporate. We've written stories on PCWorld.com about how to personalize your Windows 10 PC. But you can't really do that for Windows 11 because one of the things to personalize in Windows 10 is the Start menu. And in Windows 11, you still can't really do anything with it. In Windows 11, the Start menu is just a sea of icons with no real rhyme or reason. You can move them around and, well, that's about it. Sure, we know changes are coming. Microsoft has scheduled Start folders for release during the fall, but let's face it, they've already botched those too. One of the key visual elements of Windows 10 is the ability to visually weight specific apps and folders by resizing them. You can group Windows 11 apps together in a folder, but that makes the icons smaller. I mean, how does this make sense at a company where accessibility has been a priority? Just let us resize everything. Icons, folders, the Start menu itself. I mean, it might end up being ugly, but it's our ugly. Look, I'll be honest, I don't even use the Start menu. I simply hit the Windows key, type the name of the app, and then launch it. Or I just use the taskbar icon itself. Speaking of the taskbar, you still can't move it, you can't resize it, you can't drag files onto taskbar shortcuts and launch them. Look, I have no problem with the aesthetic. If Microsoft wants to move from Windows 8's Fisher-Price tiles all the way to a clean, orderly aesthetic with icons centered on the taskbar, that's fine. I mean, I honestly kind of like it. But Microsoft Edge allows you to vertically group tabs along the left or right edges of the screen. So why can't Windows? In Windows 11, Microsoft added widgets, Teams chat, replaced the search bar with a search icon, and essentially got rid of Cortana. I'll be honest, to me, all of these are almost worthless. I mean, as a journalist, I should use widgets and it's news and information. I don't, but I've set my Edge browser to informative, where I still get a full page of news stories every time I open a new tab. The weather icon? I mean, come on, it's always sunny in California, right? And I turned off Teams chat ages ago. It's just unnecessary in a world full of the real Teams and Zoom and Google Meet. And I simply search via browser or just tapping the Windows key. As for Cortana, well, yeah, I liked her, but now I have a phone or a smart speaker to replace her. I've generally come around on the Action Center. That's the cluster of shortcuts to different features down in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Windows 10 does provide more detail. If you're listening to a Bluetooth speaker, for example, it'll tell you. But Windows 11's organization is just better. Thankfully, now the clock appears on all of your displays. But the calendar still doesn't really do anything. It's just a desk calendar and it wastes space. Now let's talk about the Windows shell. In Windows 11, if you right-click a file, you end up with this mess of choices with new icons for cut, paste, and rename, which fortunately I've learned. But then there's this second overflow show more options menu for resizing a photo and whatnot. I mean, why does this exist? Why isn't there a single unified menu for all of this? File Explorer, I guess, is its own problem, that what a file is and where it lives is a little different in a world of Teams and Google Workspace, but Microsoft at least seems to be recognizing this. Other thoughts? Snap View. It's a subset of the Fancy Zones utility, but it works wonderfully. I'd also encourage you to tap the Windows key plus H and try out Windows Dictation. It's simple, it's effective, and you can just do it for a few seconds at a time if you want. As far as the browser is concerned, Windows 11 now allows you to designate a specific browser as your default with a single click. It didn't before. That's a step forward, but it's still kind of ridiculous that you have to designate a specific browser for opening PDF files, for example. Microsoft revamped the look and feel of the Microsoft Store app on both Windows 10 and 11, and it's far better organized and more useful as a result. Microsoft also updated some of its native Windows apps. It jumbled up Paint, a tool everyone has used, so that an entire generation had to relearn it. Microsoft also reworked Photos, releasing it with a buggy thumbnails feature, though it later fixed it. But Photos cut out my favorite feature, Spot Fix, and left the useful Magic Select tool buried inside Paint 3D, a tool that no one uses. Honestly, the strongest argument from Windows 11 comes from the PC makers themselves, which have made Windows 11 synonymous with new PCs, and especially Intel's Alder Lake chip, and its ThreadDirector tool. Otherwise, it's probably fair to say that neither two under-the-hood selling points, auto HDR or dynamic refresh rate, have made much of an impact. DRR ups the refresh rate of certain tablets for improved inking, and auto HDR adds HDR on older games without specific support. But in our testing, auto HDR didn't actually do all that much. Now, one selling point could be direct storage. In the one game we've seen demoed, Forspoken, game load times were cut to under 2 seconds. That's big. Now, Microsoft has told us about upcoming features, dragging and dropping files on a taskbar apps, the start menu folders we mentioned before, live captions, and more. But they're not here yet. Well, I mean, even if they were, the sense is that Microsoft is spending as much time playing catch up with Windows 10 as it is in launching new features for Windows 11. This is the way the system is supposed to work. Microsoft introduces new features, Windows complain or cheer, and Microsoft responds. But you can't get away from it. Even after 6 months, there just aren't many good reasons to upgrade to Windows 11.